Hey there, guys. My name is DrSharnael Wolverton Sehon. I am with Swiftfire. Super excited to talk to you about something that keeps coming up. And lots of people, I am a coach and a naturopathic doctor, so I do consultations on a regular. And over the last few weeks, they've been very, very different than anything I've ever seen before. And a lot of reoccurring things, a lot of reoccurring questions, a lot of emotional spikes, a lot of health things up and down. And so I was gonna, you know, there's been a lot of questions, and I just choose to invite you guys to take in a little bit of some information that may help you. Now, you guys may have completely already know everything about this. I've done some previous videos on this, even a few, a couple years ago, and I am still talking about this, but we know that there is such a thing called the Schumann Resonance. It's basically a measurement of the frequency or the electromagnetic field around the entire Earth. And it was actually created or found or whatever you want to call it, measured first and identified by a man named Winfried Otto Schumann in 1952. Hey, Lana. So there's something real to this. There's science to this. What's going on in the Earth's atmosphere is affecting a lot of different people, a lot of different things, a lot of different situations. You are not crazy. You are not woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. You know, a lot of the consultations that I've been doing in the last few weeks, really this last month, starting at the end of February, have been extremely, like I said, very different. And you have to understand that we are all connected. We all have these biofields around us, and then the Earth actually has like a biofield too, not just measured on the ground of what the ground and the Earth is, but also by all of the inhabitants of the people who are currently living here, as well as the DNA memory of the Earth and the DNA memory of all the people living here. So there are a lot of different things that affect the Schumann measurement. And since we're all connected, and because we have all these biofields that are bumping into each other, of course our biofields measure anywhere from 10 to 15 inches out to 8 feet, as much as we can measure right now. But the Earth has its own frequency, and that frequency is usually around 7.8 hertz. Actually 7.83 hertz to be exact. That's a measurement that has been pretty stable for a long, long time. And you know, you may have a couple spikes here and there, different things, but for as a baseline, usually the Earth is about that 7.83 hertz. Now, we have seen spikes back for different things regarding different events in history, and I have a couple videos on this, so you might have already seen this. Forgive me if you've already seen it, but we measured spikes when the OJ Simpson, when OJ was in a car like driving, because that was one of the very first times that something like an event like that was actually on the media, on the news, where everyone was all participating in the observation of that situation. And interestingly enough, the spike went really haywire high, because I guess everyone in unity who was watching, there was a collective like jump and spike in the field that happened on the Earth that day. We've also seen spikes with Princess Diana's wedding. We've seen spikes with her funeral, which was pretty sad. We've seen spikes with other events like 9/11. What's really interesting is it actually was really spiked up even before the literal event that it happened around 10, whatever, that morning. It was already spiking up, almost like we knew it was coming, like something was about to happen kind of thing, that way before the actual literal event took place. You know, you gotta wonder, like, what in the world is that about? But interestingly enough, to bring it to now here, starting at the end of February last month, and throughout March, like I said, we're normally at a 7.83 hertz, We've been spiking in the 130s and the 150s, not just for a quick spike, but on the 17th, we went up to 150, y'all. And it wasn't just for like a couple minutes. It was for 5 hours. 5 hours. There was a, what they call a whiteout in the currency, in the electric field of the earth. Something was going on. Something was happening. Something that, you know, we are still not 100% sure of what's going on. I'm sure somebody knows. But when that happens, and there is, and especially if it's like for a long, long, long period of time, 5 hours is really different than, you know, a little spike. And I can give you the analogy. If you got electrocuted, let's say, by accidentally sticking your finger in the plug socket or something for a second, that's a quick thing. But imagine being electrocuted for 5 hours. I mean, some people just didn't make it, right? So when we have a whiteout like that, it actually does shift the planet. Now, we know we've had the solar storms, and I posted a video on that. There's been different things like the moon situation going on. And, you know, we can absorb some of that in a good way and in a helpful way. But you have to understand that the water within our body, we have, you know, 70-something percent water in our body, and even more than that in our brain. And the actual hertz of the earth will vibrate, you know, those spikes actually vibrate the water within us and do affect us on a human level. And those spikes are a jolt to us physically and emotionally and mentally, even especially over a long, long period of time. So I just want to, if this helps you in any way, let you know something's going on here, not just the moon, not just the solar flares, but something literally in the electric magnetic field of the earth is happening. And we are feeling that. And so a level of humanity, some of the things that you may have experienced or felt could be these emotional highs and lows, maybe extreme irritability. You could have some crazy dreams and visions, or like a spike in intuition or prophetic realms of being able to see. Keeps calling, apologies. It's a jolt, it's a wake up, it's like a resuscitation to the heart and to your field and to the water within you. So some other things you could have, like hot flashes, you could have flu symptoms. You may feel tired. You could have extreme tiredness. A fly. You may feel, it can actually feel a bolt of energy, a bolt of ideas, a bolt of creativity. There are so many different things that everyone is affected differently. And so, you know, there could be a lot of things that are, when they're being shaken, you know, we're being shaken for real. So again, it can be good, because if you've maybe had some negative patterns going on, even from childhood or different things, a lot of times these bolts can actually shake you into a new pattern, which is kind of exciting. Or maybe some new and fresh ideas could come to the surface that had been locked down and depressed or suppressed. But when we are emotional, you know, we detox in tears, and some things will not detox. And as we kind of absorb some of that, those energies, and get to that place of being able to finally balance out a little bit, then you may see some things that are helpful for you to go forward in the future. So let me give you a couple tips on just what we can do today to help, because even today we went up to like 56 on a quick spike, and I can give you guys some links to, if you guys want to track with this. I've been tracking it for a few years off and on, not every day, but you know, I look at it, And I can drop that link in here for you. But how are some, what are some ways that we can actually go with the flow? What are some ways that we can maybe absorb some of these things a little bit differently, with a little bit more grace and ease? Number one, oiling up is a good idea. Anything in high frequency would be really, really helpful. Getting some outside air, fresh air, getting grounded, taking off your socks and shoes and putting yourself, on the grass, laying in the ground, laying in the dirt, getting really, really grounded. If you don't have anything where you can go be grounded, whether it's beach or, some of you may be on the snow, I don't know where you are. Matter of fact, if you're on this, drop me where you are. I'd love to see where you guys are and what city, what state, what country, where you guys are jumped on from. But get grounded, and essential oils are really helpful with that because it's basically nature in a bottle. So you may be in, the city in New York, a cement city. And you can put something on like that, or just get some plants, do some different things, some real plants, and eating good, eating really good nutritional things can be really, really helpful just to keep that balance and to help absorb some of those bolts a little bit. Nutrition crystals, I have a whole crystal group where I teach on the science and the education of crystals and how they record, how they can be helpful for you, how they can be a very good structural thing, how they can help structure in the middle of chaos. They can actually bring you into structure and ground you. They can do a lot of things, and there's a lot of science to this, and it's not just this oogie boogie, new age whatever. There's that biblical science knowledge on this stuff. So prayer and meditation is really helpful, because when we can get our mindset, that's going to be really, really helpful. Decrees, drinking a lot of water, getting rest. If you require rest, go freaking lay down and take a nap and just let your body do its thing. Let your body detox. Let your body assimilate what's been going on because of this, quote, shaking. Epsom salt baths are really, really good. Or just taking showers or getting in a sauna or doing something where you sweat and detox. That's really helpful. Exercise, going on a walk, like I said, doing anything where you're sweating and kind of shifting that. Nature, go camping, go to the beach. Like I said, get on a picnic or lay in the backyard. I have several times in the last few weeks just went and laid down in my grass. And I know some of my friends who have been doing similar things, if they're just gone and laying in the yard. So these can really help with, hot flashes and mood swings and flu-like symptoms and anxiety and, all of whatever can be happening. You could have extreme highs of joy and excitement, and then the next minute be opposite of that. So I hope this is helpful to you. I hope this is good news so that you're not thinking, oh my gosh, I'm losing it. One more thing too. You can have extreme hunger for things, especially things you may not usually be hungry for. So I know for me, I'm just being so super honest. I have been craving powdered white donuts for 3-4 weeks straight. Every day, waking up thinking about powdered donuts. Now, this is something I don't eat. I don't do sugar. I'm keto. But grief equals sugar. And I guess it was a tune-up and a muting of grief with some things that have been coming up. Who knows with my daughter about to be moving out or different things. My son-in-law, with his military stuff that's going on, and just a lot of, who knows? It could be cyclical, all this stuff. But I'm just saying, if you are not crazy, we are not crazy. This is just happening, and it's okay, and be okay with that, and just go with it, and do all the things that you can to kind of help the effect not be so startling and so, jolting to you. So definitely appreciate any feedback. Please share and tag, because there are some people who absolutely don't know anything about this Schumann measurement, and they could actually be thinking they're going crazy. So tell your friends and let them know that this is not them, but this is just the earth going through its cycle, and that we are we're getting into some sort of balance to this. Bringing this up too, someone mentioned technology could be having some issues. Anybody had some technology issues in the last few weeks? Holy cow, whether it's like your computer, your server, your phone, your electricity, service of any kind having to do with technology stuff. I know I got on a video the other day and my server went out on my desktop, and within minutes I got my server back, but then my electricity went out in my house, and then my phone like drained really, really quickly, cancel, and I had to go in my car to actually like plug in my phone and finish my video plugged into my phone with my car turned on. Anyone else have some crazy stuff with their phone or like bleeps or whatever? So yeah, that can be another signal of different, just because it's an electric current, you guys, that's on the planet right now, and it's affecting anything and everybody, you know, animals, all of us that are alive, and everything that has a current. So anything that can be affected and shaken can be shaken, right? Like the scriptures say. So you're not crazy. Talk to you soon. Please tag and share so people can get some help and realize some new ways that they can kind of maneuver through all this. And again, please do drop your city and state from where you're calling from. And someone's bringing up parasite. Yeah, if you got parasites, oh my Lord, it will affect the parasites too. This is a great time to do a parasite cleanse and get through with all of that. And just like, yeah, because parasites have their own energy. Good point. Thank you for bringing that up. Parasites have their own energy. So you could be dealing with not only what's going on the earth, but also what's going on with you and what's going on with the energy of the parasites. Yeah. So if you're interested in knowing more about how to do a parasite cleanse, you can inbox me and I'll talk to you about that too. But wow, people from Germany and Hawaii and Texas and Pennsylvania and all kinds of stuff. So yeah. Oh, someone almost got electrocuted twice. Oh my gosh. Yeah. So tag your friends and all the places. I so look forward to continuing to connect with you guys. Check out my website. It's swiftfire.org. You can subscribe to my YouTube. I have tons of videos on this kind of stuff, and hopefully that'll really be more helpful and connect some dots for you on science, energy, on God, on spirit, and the Bible, and connecting all this stuff. So you guys continue, and if you're not following me, definitely follow me and hit the notification button, so whenever I'm doing new videos, you guys can be alerted to hop on and see what the newest, latest is going on with all this. All right, I love you guys. Have a great one. Make it a good one. Make it a great one today. Rise above all of this and go do something fun. All right. Talk to you soon. Bye.